Hey, welcome back folks. I really hope you enjoyed watching my last video on building the copper pipe standing lab. And if you haven't already seen that, be sure to check that out first. And as I mentioned in that last video, this time we'll be making the lampshade to go with that lamp, primarily because it took me aback just how expensive large lampshades actually are. Now, whilst this is not really the best way to build a lampshade, I hope you enjoy sort of following along with me finding a more cost-effective way. To make this lampshade, we're going to need some rings, which I'm going to make out of some 3mm plywood. So I'm just starting by marking out some arcs for those rings. So now I'm just going to use this framing square to mark the ends square. And then I can cut them off at the bandsaw. Now if we break these pieces apart carefully, so I've scraped off all the hot glue from them now. A few little casualties, you can see some of the corners broke off. Not ideal, but shouldn't make a great deal of difference once it's all glued together, which is what's up next. We're going to glue two rings on top of each other, and then the second set of segments will be offset by 45 degrees, and that will help to join the segments together properly. And to do that, I'm using wood glue and just a little bit of super glue to hold it in place while it dries. So I've just about got one glued up there, and so once that's dry, I'll get on and do the next one. So I'm just going to mark the sort of collar for the bowl fitting. So that's about 10 centimeters wide. Just before I cut that out, I'm going to drill a hole the right size for the lamp fitting. I'll use the piece that I just cut out to mark up two more. So I've just cut out these three pieces, and what they're going to allow me to do is to sit in here like that, and then I'll cut some interlocking joints to fit these parts together. I've already marked 120 degrees apart on the centerpiece, so I'm just going to cut a couple of little notches in here, and I'll do some matching notches on these parts. And so that will go together like that. And then all I need to do is to attach this to the top frame. And so what I'm going to do is to just cut a little notch in each of these legs to slot into a corresponding notch that I've cut into here. So there we go, that's the frame pretty much sorted, and we'll glue this together once we've got the shade worked out. Now for the shade itself, I've got some of this self-adhesive lampshade material, and I've got some grey fabric which I used on another project. So this is going to end up being a pretty long piece, so I'm going to try and do this down on the floor. I'll first cut the PVC to size, and then I can peel off the adhesive backing and stick it to the fabric. You want to make sure you push out all of the air bubbles while you do this. Finally, I'll cut away the excess fabric, leaving a couple of centimetres of overhang. I'm actually using hot glue to glue the frame to the shade. This is not really the best adhesive to use for this job, but it's the best thing I had to hand. Now that I've got the lampshade together, I'm just going round this top edge, sticking down the turned over fabric. If I thought this through a little bit better, I would have cut the fabric long enough so that it would have stretched over the rim and round the other side, so I could have stuck it down there. So at some point I might cover this visible edge up with some trim, but for now I don't think this is going to be a huge problem because of the height the lampshade will be sitting at. So all we need to do to finish off the lampshade is just to stick the lamp mount in the centre. So to do that, I'm going to use some wood glue and a little bit of hot glue while everything sets up. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and once again, if you haven't already seen the lamp build video, be sure to do that. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.